Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create your own corporeal Patronus as seen in the Harry Potter movies. I thought it would be a fun challenge to figure out the easiest, most effective way to recreate them and then show you how to do it. In the lore of Harry Potter, a Patronus is basically a guardian which acts as a shield between you and evil spirits known as Dementors. For your convenience, I provided a Photoshop document that you could download so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description below the video or in my project files. It contains two layers, a forest background and a stag. Feel free to use your own background or your own animal if you'd like. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Invert. To restrict it to just affect the animal, we need to clip it to the animal layer. To do this, click the clipping mask icon or press Alt-Control-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create clipping mask. Click the adjustment layer icon again, click black and white, and clip it. Next, we'll convert the inverted black and white animal into a smart object so we can continue to modify it non-destructively. To do this, shift-click the animal layer to make it and the two adjustment layers active, and click the icon at the upper right corner of the layers panel. Click Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Name the copy Outer Glow. Hide the copy and make the original active. Before we continue, check your foreground and background colors. If they're not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Stylize folder and click Glowing Edges. Make the Edge Width 2, the Edge Brightness 10, and the Smoothness 15. Change the Blend Mode to Color Dodge. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Let's drag it over so we can see our animal. Click Outer Glow. The blend mode is Vivid Light, the opacity is 50%, and the color is white. The technique is Softer, the spread is 0%, and the size is 40 pixels. The contour is Linear, and the range is 50%. Click Color Overlay and the Color Box. In the hexadecimal field, type in 0096FF. The blend mode is Soft Light, and the opacity is 60%. Click Inner Glow. The color is white, the blend mode is Color Dodge, and the opacity is 60%. The size is 50 pixels, and the range is 50%. Make the copy visible and active. Reduce the fill to 0%. This hides the image, but it'll retain the full visibility of any effects we add to it. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow and the Color Box. In the hexadecimal field, type in 00A8FF. Change the blend mode to Color Dodge and the opacity to 30%. Increase the size to 250 pixels and make the range 30%. Make a copy of the layer. I'll name it Twinkles. Double-click Outer Glow to open it in the Layer Style window. Change its blend mode to Dissolve and reduce its opacity to 4%. Let's group our Patronus layers into a folder. To do this, shift-click the bottom animal layer to make all of our animal layers active and press Ctrl or Command G. I'll name the folder Stag, but you can name it whatever you like. Next, we'll add an ethereal mist around our Patronus. Open the swirling smoke file I provided. To place it onto your other document, press Ctrl or Command A to select it, and Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Open your Patronus document and press Ctrl or Command V to paste it onto the document. Change the blend mode to Screen. We'll blend the smoke more into our image by double-clicking the thumbnail of the smoke to open the Layer Style window. We'll use Blend If to blend the smoke. Basically, Blend If uses luminosity to blend layers together. This layer is our smoke layer, and the underlying layer comprises all the layers below our smoke layer. When we drag the left slider of this layer to the right, it cuts off the darkest pixels of the smoke. However, to transition the blending, Alt-click or Option-click the middle of the triangular icon. This splits it in two. Drag the right half of the icon to the right, which creates a smooth transition. Next, we'll add vapor trails using the smoke brush set I provided. Its link is also in my video's description or project files. If you're not sure how to install brushes, watch my tutorial showing how to do this. Once it's installed, open your brush tool and brush picker. Click the gear icon and click Import Brushes. Navigate to where the brushes folder is and click Free Smoke Photoshop Brushes 15. Then click Load. Scroll to the bottom of the brush picker to see the smoke brushes. Open the folder and scroll down it to see all the brushes you can use within this folder. I'll click this one. All the brushes in this set are 2500 pixels in size. To reduce its size, press Enter or Return, and then press the left bracket key on your keyboard a number of times. Press X to invert your foreground and background colors. White should be your foreground color. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer, and press Ctrl or Command G to place it into a folder. Name the folder Vapor Trails. Change the blend mode to Overlay, and make the empty layer active. If the brush isn't angled to your image in the way you'd like it to be, press the R key on your keyboard and rotate your canvas. Press B to open back your brush tool, and left-click once to stamp the brush onto your image. To see your canvas right side up, open your Navigator window. If you don't see it, go to Window and Navigator. I'll undo the brush by pressing Ctrl or Command Z. To rotate your canvas back to normal, press R again, and press and hold the Shift key as you rotate it until it snaps in place. I'll click here for the brush. If you want to warp the vapor trail, open your Transform tool and click the Warp Transform icon. Drag the lines and the points until you like its shape. Then, click the check mark at the top. Continue to add vapor trails as separate layers within the Vapor Trails folder. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.